The rule of 72 is a great rule that everyone should know how to use. It is a very simple rule. Basically, it says this: if I put up money in an investment and I'm getting a certain interest rate at a fixed amount, if I take the number 72 and divide by that interest rate, that is the number of years it'll take to double my money. For example, if I have $10,000 to invest and I'm earning 9% interest rate, 72 divided by 9 is 8 years. That $10,000 will double to $20,000. That is the rule of 72. Let's dive in and test it and talk about some key takeaways about the rule of 72 using Excel. I'm Chris Menard. This Excel file will be available for you to download. Here we go right now with the rule of 72. Example one is what I just said. $10,000 is in cell F2, 8%. I type that in cell F3. I did a quick formula to get the 9 years. That is 72 divided by 8 is 9 years. And then I put in F2 times 2 to see what that would be future value or being doubled. Now, let's see how accurate it is. So we're going to use the future value function equal FV. Interest rate is cell F3. The number of periods is cell F4. Payment is 0, or you can leave it blank. And then finally, present value. I want to see a positive number, so I'm going to do negative F2. Really close. $10,000 at 8% interest. 9 years. We're not putting any more money in. We're just sitting it in one time. $19,990. Extremely close. You will find with the rule of 72, anything between 6% to 10% out to maybe 12%, it is extremely accurate. But if you get into lower interest rates below 6% or really high rates of return, it gets off. It'll either be underestimated or overestimated. So let's look at example two. $10,000, 2%, it should double in 36 years, according to the rule of 72, to $20,000. If I pull this Excel function over, if you notice, it underestimates it when the interest rates start getting below 6%, 2%. We don't need 36 years for that to double. It would have doubled before 36 years. Now, here's an easy example about something with an interest rate way over. If I have $10,000 at 72%, 72 divided by 72 is 1 year. Well, I'm not going to end up with $20,000 in 1 year because 72% of $10,000 is $7,200. So this one's going to be underestimated in the value right there. So if you're wondering exactly how long will it take to double, we use the future value. Here's another great function. It is NPER. I'm in cell F7. NPER returns the number of pairs for an investment based on periodic constant payments and a constant interest rate. That's exactly what I want. What is our interest rate? That is cell F3. The payment is still 0, or leave it blank. Present value, we've got $10,000, comma. This future value, if you notice, it's in brackets, it's optional, but you do want to use it. It is going to be cell F5. It is the $20,000 in this example. And it is telling us that instead of 9 years at 8%, it would technically double in 9.01 years. If I pull that over to the 2%, you can see that 2%, we're going to do this in 35 years instead of 36. And then if we go out to the 72, this one should take longer than 1 year, and sure enough, 1.28. So there's your underestimating for lower interest rates and overestimating for higher interest rates. And it's all, by the way, the over and under is based on the amount of time. So that's the amount of time right there. I hope you enjoyed this. I love the rule 72 because historically the S&P 500 has had annual returns depending on whether you go out 10 years, 15, 20, or 30, but it's been between 10% up to 13% for that. So this is a very accurate function if you're looking at the stock market over a long period of time. Appreciate your time. My online training is available for Excel, Teams, OneNote, and Copilot. Have a great day. Thank you.